Hello, welcome to The Update. I'm Susie Thompson. The first criminal case against Donald Trump is set to proceed to trial in New York. He's to stand trial next month in the hush money case involving adult film star Stormy Daniels. The former US president remains defiant.
I'm being indicted for you, and never forget. Our enemies want to take away my freedom because I will never let them take away your freedom.
Still in the US, and police in Kansas City say a dispute appears to have been behind a deadly shooting at the Super Bowl parade. A woman was killed and more than 20 other people wounded, seven with life-threatening injuries. Three people remain in police custody. Back home, and the Fair Work Ombudsman has fined the Commonwealth Bank and ComSec a record $10.3 million for underpaying staff. The Ombudsman says almost 7,500 employees across Australia were underpaid between 2015 and 2021, many of them in customer service. The penalties are the highest ever secured in legal action by the Fair Work Ombudsman. A cyclone building in the Gulf of Carpentaria is expected to affect at least three states over the next week. The Weather Bureau has issued a cyclone warning for coastal communities from Port Roper to the Northern Territory-Queensland border. It's expected to weaken as it heads inland across the Top End and head into Western Australia next week. The lights are gradually coming back on across Victoria, where more than 90% of the 500,000 customers cut off in Tuesday's storm are now back online. Latest figures show 44,000 customers remain without power. AusNet is installing a large generator in the Gippsland town of Merbau North, which has been especially hard hit. While in Victoria's west, people evacuated from the Grampians town of Pomonal have been allowed to return home, but at least 25 homes have been destroyed by a bushfire that began with dry lightning. Sport and entertainment are next. In sport, the Aussie women have dominated the opening day of their one-off test match against South Africa at the Wacker. The home side won the toss and bowled first, dismissing the Proteas for just 76, Darcy Brown snaring a five-wicket haul. The Aussies reached stumps at 5 for 251, recovering from 3 for 12, thanks to a 155-run partnership between Beth Mooney and skipper Elisa Healy. Healy fell just one run short of a test century. And the NRL's pre-season ramps up tonight with the All-Stars games in Townsville. The women's Indigenous and Maori stars go head-to-head this afternoon, with the men to follow tonight. Last night, the Bulldogs beat the Storm 24 points to 12. In entertainment news, excitement levels are rising across Melbourne as fans of Taylor Swift prepare for her show at the MCG tonight. Fans are encouraged to take public transport to and from the venue. Extra tram and train services have been scheduled over the next 3 days. And that is the latest from the Nova podcast team. We'll see you later on for another update. I'm Susie Thompson.